Hello friends, once again welcome back in my YouTube channel. It's Learn Oracle series, and today I'm going to start with the most important topic in the database. It's constants. We need to cover the primary key, unique, not null, check, default, foreign key, on delete casket, on delete set null, deferring constants, and some other keywords are also there that we need to take care. In any database, this is the most important thing that always we need to consider, especially the constants, the joins and the subqueries. That's really the fundamental for any database, especially in the SQL. So let me start with the session. For the previous video, like the select statement, like the joins and the basic Oracle statements, it's already there in the channel. So you can go through all the previous video to get the maximum benefit of this series. So let me start with the session. At first, I'm going to start with connector/tiger. So first of all, what exactly the constants is? It is used to put certain restrictions or validations on the table or tables column. So if we want to put certain restrictions or validations over the table or the tables column, we have to use the constants. The most important thing, the types of constants are: number one, we are having primary key. A table can have maximum one primary key. In any circumstances, a table cannot have more than one primary key. That we need to take care. A table can have maximum one primary key. Primary key is the main key of the table. Remember, by default, it's unique and not null. Unique means what? You cannot make any duplicate entry. Not null means what? You cannot make it blank. And the third thing is, can be foreign key. Remember, to be a foreign key, that key must be the primary key in another table. So this is these three properties are there that we need to take care. The second one is the unique key. Unique. Remember, a table can have any number of unique key. Any number of unique key. In unique key, null is allowed. Null is allowed. Remember, can't be foreign key. In any interview, this question will be there, like, what is the difference between primary key and unique? And you just need to give these three points as the difference between primary key and unique. A table can have maximum one primary key. A table can have any number of unique key. By default, it's unique and not null. Null is not allowed in primary key, but in unique, null is allowed. Primary key can be foreign key, but unique can't be foreign key. So these three differences always you need to remember. This is the guaranteed question for your interview. Now, the third point is, like, we are having not null. Not null means blank, not allowed. Every time you need to enter the value in the table, in the fields, blank, not allowed. The fourth one is the check. Used to validate. Like, I want to put the validation like Sally's would be greater than 2000. For this, we have to use the check constants. The next one is default to assign default values. If I'm not going to insert the value in that particular field, this default value will get assigned. Last but not least, we are having the foreign key is used to make the relation. Remember, foreign key must be primary key of another table. In foreign key, a table can have any number of foreign key. In foreign key, null is allowed, blank is allowed, null is allowed, duplicate is allowed. Remember, foreign key must be primary key in another table. Where we define foreign key is known as child table, or we can say it as detail table. And where we define primary key is known as master table or the parent table. So this is all about the constraints. In Oracle, even it's not only in Oracle, even in SQL Server, in MySQL, we are having the six types of constraints are there. It's primary key, unique, not null, check, default, and foreign key. Now I am going to create a table. Create table test 9. In the test 9, I am going to create the table with constants. Role is of type number of 4. And I am going to define it as primary key. Name is there, is of type varchar2 of 20. And I am going to define it as unique. Address is there, is of type varchar2 of 20. And I am going to define it like not null. Again, I am going to give marks is of type number of 4. And I am going to apply check marks greater than 100. This is how we can apply the check constants. Again, I am going to apply the phone is of type number of 10. And default, I am going to give 9650886499. Column check constant cannot reference other column. Okay, some syntax problem is there. Once again, check mark greater than 100. Phone is of type this one. Yeah, table get created. Now what we need to do, I am going to insert the value. Insert into test 9 values. Roll number 1. Name I am going to give like Santos. Address I am going to give like GZB. Marks I am going to give. Suppose I am going to give 33, comma. So phone number I am going to give. See, we are getting the error. The error is check constant violated. The problem is, we just applied the check constants on marks. It should be greater than 100. But here we are writing like 33. That's the problem. That's why we are getting the error message check constant violated. So what we need to do, I need to give the value. It should be more than 300, 100. Yeah, now it's fine. So this is all about the check constants. Suppose again I am going to repeat the same record, you will get the error. The problem is unique constant violated. You are using, once again you are using 1. 1 was the defined as it's a primary key column, so always it should be unique. So I am going to give 2, but still the problem will be there. Like you need to define the name is basically, it was unique. So in the name always you need to give some unique values. Okay, in the name again I am going to give some unique values. Suppose I am going to give Razib. Yeah, it's perfectly fine. So suppose in the primary key again I am going to give this value. In the name I am going to give this one, and here I am going to give the value in roll comma ADDR only. I am not going to give the value in name. I am just going to give the value in roll and address. Yeah, it's inserted. Again I am going to give the value. Again it's inserted. Again I am going to give the value. Again it's inserted. Select star from test 9. This is the roll number we are having. Name. Name was defined as unique. In unique, null is allowed. See. Address, it was not null. Marks, it was fine. And this is all about the default constraints. We did not give the value for the phone number, and that's why this default value is assigned over here. So this is what the concept of default. This is what the concept of unique that we need to take care. So this is all about the primary key, unique, not null. Okay, just let me check with the not null. Suppose I am going to give the value, and I am not going to give the value in address. I am not going to give the value in address, and you will get the error, like cannot insert the null into ADDR because it was defined as not null. So again, always you need to give the value for address. So I am going to give the value for ADDR address, and I am just mentioning the value like this. So this is all about the constraints. Select star from test 9. So these are the basic information that we need to take care. In this particular table, we are having the primary key, we are having the unique, we are having the not null, we are having the check constants, and we are having the default. Now what we need to do, we need to define the relation. Okay. Let me give the practical example. Suppose I am going to start a software company. In my software company, naturally some department will be there and some employee will be there. So at first I am going to define the department table. So I am going to define create table department 1. In department 1, I am going to give department number. Department number is of type number of 2, and I am going to make it primary key. Comma, department name will be there, varchar 2 of 20. Now I am going to insert the value, insert into department 1 values. The department number is 10, and department number is suppose EDP. Department number, again I am going to give department number 20, and the department number is account. So we have created the table department. In department table we are having department number and department name. I need to start with the company, so I am going to create the department table, and in my company there is only 2 departments. It department EDP is there and account department is there. Naturally, because it's a company, so some employee has to join. So I am going to create the table for the employee. Create table EMPL1. In EMPL1 I am going to give like employee number is of type number of 4, and I am going to define it as a primary key. Employee name is of type varchar 2 of 20, and again I am going to use like salary is of type number of 4, and again I am going to give like department number is of type number of 2, and I am going to define as references. So references is the keyword to define the foreign key. references, and I need to give the reference of department 1, department number. So table get created. Now I am going to insert the value, insert into EMPL1 values, employee number. The first employee is going to join in my company, and the employee name is suppose Sanjay. And again I am going to give the salary, suppose 5000. Now the important thing that we need to mention over here, the department, because in my company only there is two department, it's 10 and 20, and we are using the references over here. Means what? Suppose I am going to give 30. Practically in my company only two department is there, then how the employee can join in department 30? Only 10 and 20 is there, so you will get the error. And why we are getting this error? Because we are using the foreign key. This is exactly the concept of foreign key. Like here, always we need to put the value. That value should be available in this particular table because we are defining the foreign key. This is the concept of foreign key, and this is the practical example. Because we are having the department number 10 and 20 only, so how the employee can join in department 30? So always you need to give the value, and we are getting the error properly. Integrity constant violated. This is called referential integrity, and we are getting the message parent key not found. Naturally 30 is not there, so what I need to give, I am going to give 10. Yeah, it's perfectly fine. Again, the next employee is going to join in my company, it's Mandeep, and salary will be 6000, and either it will be in 10 or 20. Suppose I am going to give 10. Yeah, it's fine. Suppose I am going to give 20, it's fine. But I cannot give 40, I cannot give 30, because these departments is not available in my company, and here we are defining the reference, here we are defining the foreign key. So I am going to give department 10. Yeah, it's perfectly fine. Select star from department 1, select star from EMPL1. So this one is my master table. In master table we are having the primary key, department number 10 and 20 is there, and here we are using foreign key. Here we are using foreign key. Like, so again I am going to insert the value, like insert into, and I am going to give the value in employee number comma employee name, and I am going to give the values like 3. Once again, I am writing employee number comma employee name, values I am going to give like employee number 3. I am going to give this one. Again, I am going to give the value. Again, I need to give the value. Select star from EMPL1. See, in foreign key, null is allowed. I don't have any problem. Duplicate is allowed. But the important thing is that whatever the value we need to insert over here, that must be defined in the parent table. That's exactly the concept of foreign key. In foreign key, null is allowed. See, we don't have the values over here. In foreign key, duplicate is allowed. So we don't have, yeah, the duplicate value is there. So that's the important information that we need to take care about the foreign key. Now, so we are having the table called select star from department 1, and we are having the table called select star from EMPL1. Now what I am looking for, suppose I need to close this department number 10 EDP, because it's not profitable for me. So I am the owner of the company and I can remove the department. So I am just going to remove the department 10, delete from department 1 where department number is equal to 10, and I will get the error over here. Yeah, sorry, department 1, and we are getting the message integrity constant violated, child record found. Because you are going to remove the department number 10, but the corresponding child record is available over here. So at first, what we need to do? At first, we need to remove the child record, and after that, we can remove this parent record. This is the fundamental. Naturally, I need to close the department. Naturally, at first, I need to adjust these employee over here. I need to remove the these records, and after that, I can close this department. So this is what the concept of primary key and foreign key is. So at first, now we need to remove. I am going to remove EMPL 1, where department number is equal to 10, two rows deleted. Then I need to remove this. Now it's perfectly fine. So this is what the concept of foreign key and primary key that we need to take care. Now, the one important thing is there, like we are having the concepts of on delete casket. We are having the concept of on delete casket. What exactly the on delete casket is? Suppose I am going to create the table. EMPL2. In EMPL2, I am going to use employee number. Employee name, salary, and again I am going to define the foreign key. Department number is of type number of 2, references department 1, department number, and here I am going to use the keyword on delete casket. I am going to insert the value, insert into EMPL2, values, employee number, employee name, salary, and I am going to give the department like 20. Yeah, it's perfectly fine. Again, I am going to give the value, employee number 2, employee name is this one, and this is the salary we are having. Again, I am going to give 20. Again, I am going to give another like 30. This one, this is the salary, and again, I am going to give 20. Select star from department 1. And this is my table EMPL2. Now, what I need to do, I just need to remove this department. So, I am going to remove that. Delete from department 1, where department number is equal to 20. So, because I am going to remove this department, so these child record will get removed automatically. Why it will remove automatically? Because we are using on delete casket. So this is what the concept of on delete casket. Earlier there was the problem. Earlier there was the restriction, like at first I need to remove the child record. After that it will remove, and then we can go for the parent record. But here I am going to remove the parent record directly. I am not going to remove the child record. It will automatically remove this child record. Yeah. One row deleted. And now I am going to use select star from EMPL2, no row selected, these records get removed automatically. So this is the concept of foreign key and primary key with on delete casket. On delete casket means what? When we remove the parent record, it will also remove the child corresponding child record. It's fine. Okay. Now we are having the concept of on delete set null. So what exactly the on delete set null is? Let me insert some value in department table. Insert into department 1 values. I am going to give department number 30 and department name is suppose EDP. Again I am going to give some value like department number 40, and again I am going to give like account. Apply the commit command over there. Now I am going to create the table. Create table EMPL3. In EMPL3, I am going to use employee number, employee name, employee number, employee name, salary is there. And I am going to use department number is of type number, references from department 1, department number. And here we are using on delete set null. Now I am going to insert the value. Insert into EMPL3 values. I am going to give employee number, employee name, salary, and in department number, suppose I'm going to give department number 30. Again, I'm going to insert the value, employee number, employee name, and again I'm going to give 30. Again, I'm going to insert the another value. This 3 is there, and again I'm going to give 30. So select star from department 1. Again, I'm going to use select star from EMPL3. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to remove this parent record. Delete from department 1, where department number is equal to 30. This record deleted. Apply the command select star from EMPL3. See, now these values are null over there. Why it is null? Because when we created the table, just we applied on delete set null. So this is all about the on delete set null. So two things is there that we need to remember. It's on delete casket. On delete casket means what? When you remove the parent record, it will automatically remove the child record. And the second one is on delete set null. When you remove the parent record, the value in the child record will get assigned null automatically. So this is about the primary key, foreign key, unique, not null, check, default. These things are there. Okay. Now the next thing is we are having level of constructs. Level of constructs. What exactly the level of constraint is? There is first one is the column label constraints. When we define the constraint like this, create table, the name of the table, and suppose I am going to use roll is of type number of 2, and I am going to make it primary. Name is of type varget 2 of 20. This is your column label constraints. And number 2 is table label. This is again, we can also define the constraint like this. Roll. I'm not going to define the primary key over here. Again, I'm going to use name. And at last, I'm going to give primary key roll. When we define the constraint like this, is known as table label constraints. So say there is two different way to define the constraint. One is column label and the second one is the table label. Now the important thing is, what is the use of this table label? This one is the good enough, then why it's required the table label? Basically, table label constraint is used to define the composite primary key. So what exactly the composite primary key? Remember, a table can have maximum one primary key. And again, this can be your interview question. Might be in the interview you are going to give the answer like a table can contain maximum one primary key. The interviewer will ask you the question like what is composite primary key then? So remember, composite primary key means what? The primary key will be one, but it work in combination of column. Table label constraint is used to define the composite primary key. And composite primary key means what? Primary key will be one, but will work in combination. Suppose I am going to define the table, create table, TBL company. In the TBL company, I am going to give like location. Location is suppose varget 2 of 20. And I am going to give employee number is of type number of 4. And again, I am going to give employee name is of type varget 2 of 20. And I am going to define the composite primary key. I am writing primary key. And this primary key will be based on location as well as on the employee number. this is the practical example of the composite primary key. Suppose one company is there, suppose the company is SCL. The location of SCL, it's in Noida, it's in Bangalore, it's in USA. So the location will be the different. In location Noida, the employee number 101 can exist. In location Bangalore, the employee number 101 can also exist. In location Chennai, the employee number 101 can also exist. So location is different in these three cases. The location is different, but the employee number is same. So I'm going to insert the value. Insert into TBL company values. Location I'm going to give, suppose Noida. And in employee number I'm going to give 101. Like employee name is this one. Yeah, it's perfectly fine. Once again I'm going to give the entry. Like the location is Chennai. And in Chennai again 101 is there by the name of this one. So normally you think that okay, 101, it's a duplicate. No, this is not the way to check the uniqueness of this. Because my primary key was the combination of location and employee number. So what we need to check? We need to check location in Noida, employee number is 101, location is Chennai, employee number is 101. So in the combination, it's a unique values. So this is what exactly the concept of composite primary key. And composite primary key, this we need to define on the table level only. On the column level, we cannot define the composite primary key. So this is all about the concepts of composite primary key. So thanks a lot. For the next series on the constraints, you need to view our next video. In this particular video, this was all about the fundamental, about the constraints. In the next series, I will go with the advanced concept of the constraints. It was with the advanced concepts over there. But for the time being, what you need to do, you just need to do the practice of these stuff. And one important thing, if there will be any comments from your side, you can give the comment in your feedback and all. And if you are really enjoying the video, please like the video, please subscribe the video, give some comments. It's a motivation for me. So thanks a lot.